This telescope now, it's 100 years old.
It's breathtaking.
It's something that you could just stare at for hours and hours.
This is Robert Picardo, and you're watching The Planetary Post. Welcome back, space fans. I am here in the kitchen of the Planetary Society headquarters in Pasadena, California, because we are celebrating NASA's 60th birthday. And by sheer coincidence, we are also celebrating my 65th birthday this month. So we have two cakes here. This first one is obviously for NASA. It says, Happy 60th Birthday, NASA, and it's got some cool red, white, and blue icing artwork. And where's mine? Okay, let's light these up. Okay, happy birthday, NASA and Bob. I wished for 60 more years of incredible space exploration, and that we discover life on Europa or elsewhere as soon as possible, and that I get a bigger cake next year. Next, it's Astronomy Day on October 13th, and I wanted to learn more about one of the most iconic observatory locations in the whole world, the Mount Wilson Observatory. This is where many world-changing discoveries were made, including the one in 1929, that the universe is indeed expanding. Here's my good friend and Planetary Society Outreach Coordinator, Giovanni Somoza, with a special private tour for Planetary Post viewers of the historic Mount Wilson Observatory.
Welcome to Mount Wilson Observatory. We're here above Los Angeles at 5,700 feet above sea level. Come on, follow me. This is the famous Einstein Bridge. In 1931, Einstein visited Mount Wilson Observatory, so I'm now standing in the footsteps of Einstein. The only difference is he actually had a little more hair than I did. This is it. This is the famous 100-inch telescope. This is being supported by tubs of liquid mercury. This platform can ride up and down and then left to right. So as you aim the telescope in awkward positions and you needed to reach where the eyepiece was, you would just take that platform and ride that along. Because it would be difficult to continue using that platform up there for public use, we now have this light tube. We're sending the light from the 100-inch telescope and to this smaller telescope here. So in essence, we're using a telescope to look through a telescope. We have so many discoveries with this telescope that we would basically be here all night talking about all of them. So I just want to mention one of the most famous ones, which is the fact that we discovered that Andromeda was its own galaxy. And as Hubble imaged this galaxy, which he didn't know then it was its own galaxy, he was marking all the nova that he was discovering. And when he marked this one, he later realized that's not a nova. So he crossed out the nova marking and wrote variable or VAR, because now that he knows that that's a variable star, he can finally get the distance to this object. And in getting the distance, we proved that this is a galaxy outside our own. The reason why Einstein came here in 1931 was because this telescope discovered the expansion of the universe. And so Einstein felt that that was his biggest blunder, that he did not account for the expansion of the universe. So when we finally discovered that with this magnificent telescope, he felt compelled to visit the telescope, and he felt compelled to meet the astronomers that made that discovery. That's why Einstein came here. Watch your step. We're about 50 feet up on this catwalk. every time I'm up here, it always feels like the sunset is different. And today, we're actually seeing a little bit of the effect from the nearby wildfires. This telescope now, it's 100 years old. The 60-inch, it's 110 years old. So there is that connection of how they operated the telescopes back then and what they must have thought when they saw it. Because when I look at objects, even to this day, I'm still amazed. First time I saw Saturn, I actually cried. And I'm not the only one that has those feelings. We often get people that come up here and just break down because it's so beautiful. It's breathtaking. It's something that you can just stare at for hours and hours. By the way, we just have a few more minutes to enjoy this. We're watching the Earth cast a shadow into space right there. And as the last little bits of light bend over the horizon, we get this beautiful pinkish glow off in the opposite side of the setting sun. This is our own shadow, and it's beautiful. Just when you thought it couldn't get any prettier, check out the rising moon.
Thanks, Gio, and happy Astronomy Day to everyone. Remember to go outside and look up. Last thing before we go, we celebrated World Space Week earlier this month. People from around the globe got together to celebrate space exploration, science, technology, and how all these things make life better for us here on Earth. So, we thought it might be fun to share with you some of the greetings recorded by the World Space Week participants. So here they are in many languages saying, Happy World Space Week.
विश्व बाह्याकाश सप्ताहद शुभाशयगळु
ಸ್ಯಾವಾಸೆ ನ ಸೆಕೈ ನ ಉಚೂ ಶೂಕಾಂ
ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ವೀಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ನೈಜೀರಿಯಾ
ಶಿಜೆ ಯಿ ಹಾಂಜೋ ಕ್ವೈಲೆ
ಫ್ರೂಹೆ ವೆಲ್ಟ್ರಾಂವೋಕೆ
ಫೆಲಿಚೆ ಸೆಟ್ಟಿಮಾನಾ ಮೊಂಡಿಯಾಲೆ ದೆಲ್ಲೋ ಸ್ಪಾಜಿಯೋ
ಜೆಸಿ ಮೆನ್ ಫುಲಾ ಟೆವೆಯೋ
ಕ್ಲೌಡ್ರಿನ್ ವೆಕ್ಕಾ
ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ವೀಕ್
ಗೆಲಕಾ ವರಲ್ಡ್ ರೈನ್ಫೋರ್ಟ್ ದಾಗ್
Happy World Space Week!
Happy World Space Week!